I got broads in Atlanta, just the lean in the family, credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the van, legacies, family, wait and see, look like a panda, going out like a-
Marcus? Okay, Marcus? Fourth and 11, why are you guys going for it on fourth and 11? The game is over. You guys didn't score. Oh, they scored. I lied. Damn. That's tough. He caught it. What is an onside gonna do for you guys? Tell me. You're not doing anything. Useless clowns and buffoons. Y'all both. Looks like I have 11 minutes left, so let's just hop into this analysis really quickly. Let's go over the Titans first. The Titans are a young team. The Titans are fairly young in terms of their wide receiving core, in terms of their quarterback, and in terms of their running backs. You know, DeMarco Murray is, I think he is either 29, 28, or 30. And he was off. He was injured the whole postseason. He was injured toward the end. I think he got injured week 16 or something like that. But they have Derrick Henry back there, and he shows that he can play on an NFL level in terms of running back and, you know, getting substantial yardage like he did in college at Alabama. Not too many Alabama running backs do that well in the NFL. And in terms of T.J. Yeldon, who else? Trent Richardson got finished. Mark Ingram just started to blossom these past couple of years. Who else? I already said T.J. Yeldon. Shit. Who else is running? Well, Kenyon Drake. He's on light. The running backs that come out from Alabama are never... Because at Alabama, they have, like, one of the best offensive lines ever. And they're mostly a running team. And they run it down your throat. So their yardage and the way they gain the yards and how dominant they look is, you know, a little bit overhyped when they come to the NFL. Derrick Henry obviously showed he can, you know, show out against a playoff team in the Kansas City Chiefs. So they have something bright over there. Their defense, they have, they're pretty young in the secondary. They have a first-team All-Pro secondary player in Kevin Byard, who's in his second year. So he'll, you know, improve and get better and better. He got 8 picks this year, something he probably will not reproduce on a consistent basis. I can see him being a 6-5 interception year guy. 8 is a lot. Adoree Jackson's going to improve. He's a speedy guy, and once he gets more wisdom, he'll be more savvy and be more of a shutdown corner, because he can keep up with any wide receiver in terms of speed. It's just that he needs to be more savvy and not get picked apart by, you know, opposing quarterbacks. So that's that. I mean, they're good there. You know, the defensive line is high. You know, the linebacker is high. You know, they're an high team, and they're in the AFC South. They could probably make the wild card again next year. We have to see Marcus Mariota's progression, because, you know, I honestly don't know what direction this team needs to go in, because they're all right all around. It's not like there's one glaring issue. I mean, besides the youth that I see, it's just that, like, I don't know if they should become more of an offensive team or become more of a defensive team. We'll see how they progress. But they'll be in the tournament, or at least in the hunt for the playoffs every single year in terms of wild card, and also because they're in the AFC South as well. You know, Andrew Luck is still on an abysmal team. The Jaguars are, you know, we're seeing it right now. They have taken that next step. Then you have the Houston Texans. AFC South might go from the worst division of football to the best division of football. Who knows? Who knows? And in worst division of football, I mean, for years and years and years now, even when Peyton Manning was there, they were the laughing stock of the NFL, because no team in the AFC South could even dethrone Peyton Manning. And when Peyton Manning went out on a team, they went like 0-16 or something like that. And with him, they were winning the AFC South every single year. So, you know, we'll see. Maybe next year, you know, Deshaun Watson comes back, Jags will be back and better, and the Titans will be back and better. They might be the best division in football. We'll see how that goes. That's all pretty much I have to say about the Titans. This score was expected. Nothing they did was unexpected. They showed some flash points, but, I mean, they scored on the New England secondary, and that's, like, you know, not the best secondary out there, to be honest with you, but... That is what it is there. So let's hop over to the Patriots. Nothing here that was unexpected. We just saw a different player making plays all over the field, but still Tom Brady stamped all over it. Let's go over the offense first. Tom Brady picked apart and dissected this defense. And this defense has a first-team All-Pro, as I've been saying. Kevin Byard, who picked off 8 times and was talking that smack. They also have Brian Arakpo, too. And Brian Arakpo was a Pro Bowler. He did have a really good, he had one or two really good seasons with Ryan Kerrigan in Washington. So I don't want to sleep on him either. And then, you know, they also have a running game that should have been able to keep New England off the field. But we'll talk about the defense later. The offense picked apart the defense in terms of passing the ball. Didn't do too many runs and gashes, but I'm pretty sure the New England got substantial yards. They always attempt to be pretty balanced in terms of running the football. They like to establish a running game minimum. They don't like to impose running game on all the games, but they like to at least establish some sort of running game, even if it doesn't even produce any yards. So that was established with Deion Lewis, who can show, he's been showing consistently. He can run in between the tackles, he can pick up yards, he can run through tackles, and he can be very shifty for a small guy. And he's durable. He's compact and he's durable. That's one thing. You know, Rex Burkhead hurt. My other dude, Mike Gillisley, hurt. So, you know, it's great to see, like, him and James White, the two smallest compact guys on the team, being able to stay healthy the whole year. It's very remarkable. It's something I want to, you know, really emphasize, because I really appreciate, you know, everything. You know, I can't really appreciate it, because injury has it doesn't show anybody, you know, any type of difference. But, you know, it's great to see him play. I mean, all the players in the playoffs are injured in a sense. They're all nicked up. They're all struggling to freaking walk after games because something in their leg hurts, because they've been stepped on by, like, the biggest freaking cleat size ever, especially in this cold weather game. Shoulders are sore. So I'm just appreciate him being able to come out, you know, for most of the season compared to, like, all the other running backs on the team and James White. James White was good. Well, James White and Deion Lewis are practically the same players, just that Deion Lewis has more experience in the NFL. Pretty much it. But I was really, really excited when New England put James White on the practice team coming out of Wisconsin. I love James White and Melvin Gordon combination. But, you know, that combination between Deion Lewis and James White came to head today. They couldn't guard either of them. The safeties couldn't guard them, and the linebackers couldn't guard them. Gronk, as usual, was unstoppable. Tom Brady, as usual, was picking apart the defense, giving it to Gronk, giving it to two running backs. Danny Amendola was finding the holes, catching those first down catches on third down. Everything was looking beautiful and pretty on the offensive side. Took a couple of sacks, but it looks like Tennessee Titans couldn't do anything to stop it. And then when you go over to New England's defense, they got five sacks, maybe, I think, six. Maybe they got more on a mobile quarterback, which is very, very impressive. Marcus Mariota, as you saw, could outrun some of those D linemen, but they completely collapsed the pocket a lot more than send end rusher after him so he can run around them. So it was good to see that. James Harrison was also playing some good time as well. The linebacker seems solid. The secondary is a little shaky, but they proved again that there's a reason why they're the fifth-ranked defense in points allowed. They only let up pretty much 7 points the whole game. That last touchdown, I'm not even going to count it, to be honest with you guys. I mean, you can't count it if you want. Oh, you can't count it just because you're Patriots. Nah, because, fuck, it didn't do anything. So, pretty much you give only 7 points this game. I mean, yes, again, we're going against the young team, but it's good to show that we bent and didn't break at all, and that we're just going to continue that momentum throughout the playoffs. Especially, it's going to be needed again for next week when we go against Jacksonville Jaguars. Last time I looked at the score for the Steelers game, it was 28-7. And this throw, it was 2-minute warning left in the first half. Geez, do you think the Steelers are going to come back against the Jags? I don't think so. And that's not going to be a comic thing. That's just going to be what is reality, because I don't think Steelers are going to come back against the Jags. I have told you guys I am super scared of the Jags, because there's only two things that are super effective in the playoffs, unless you're a Hall of Fame player. Run game, defense. Quarterback play has been shown historically that sometimes it just doesn't matter. That's literally what the Jacksonville Jaguars have. And you guys know how crazy I get when I talk about all these players on Jacksonville Jaguars defense. And then you have the... I'm not even going to get into it. But it's going to be Patriots versus Jags. The Jags right now are playing super, super cold conditions in Pittsburgh. If they can bring that game into New England, it's going to be the Denver Broncos versus New England. What year was it? 2015 all over again, pretty much. And then we'll have to see from there. Because Leonard Fournette got injured. I don't know the severity of the injury. If he's out, we'll have to see what other dude is there. Other dude that played for Jets is there. He can't come to mind, but y'all know who I'm talking about, the running back. We'll see if he and TJ Yeldon are enough to carry them. I don't think so. I got the Patriots winning that game just off gut, but not head. And you guys know what I'm talking about. Like, my, you know, just logically, I don't think the Patriots offensively can overcome that Jags defense. But just by gut, I'm going with Tom Brady to win the game next week. 21 to, like, 17. Or freaking 17 to 10 or something like that. Comment down below if you guys think Patriots are going to be the Jaguars. Comment down below if you guys think the Titans are going to be able to get back to the playoffs next year in the AFC South with Deshaun Watson back. And comment down below if you guys think that, if you guys think the Patriots are going to be able to have an effective offense against the Jags next week. I'm ODJ. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment. Thank you for watching all the way through. If you did, this video is long as fuck. I'll catch you guys in my next video. Deuce.